Well, hello to you today. This is Pastor. We're on the porch, and I want to share on prayer a word from the Word. It's found in 1 Timothy, the second chapter, and I'm going to read a few verses here out of the Passion Bible. It says this: "Most of all, I'm writing to encourage you to pray with gratitude to God. Pray for all men with all forms of prayers and requests, as you intercede with intense passion. And pray for every political leader and representative, so that we would be able to live tranquil, undisturbed lives as we worship the awe-inspiring God with pure hearts. It is pleasing to our Savior God to pray for them. He longs for everyone to embrace his life and return to the full knowledge of the truth. For God is one, and there is one mediator between God and the sons of men, the true man, Jesus, the Anointed One. He gave himself as a ransom payment for everyone. Now it is the proper time for God to give the world this witness. I have been divinely called as an apostle to preach this revelation, which is the truth. God has called me to be a trustworthy teacher to the nations. Therefore, I encourage the men to pray on every occasion with hands lifted to God in worship, with clean hearts, free from frustration and strife." The New Living Bible says, "Pray this way for kings and for all who are in authority, so we can live peaceful and quiet lives marked by goodness and dignity." You know, the right response is to pray for leaders and those in authority. Not pray against them, but to pray for them. Now, how are we to pray? Well, we're to pray for them. And what are we to pray? God's kingdom come, God's will and way be done in them and then through them. You know, prayer is man's invitation for God's intervention. It gives God access to use his authority and his ability. And it make the one translation says that the fervent, heartfelt prayers of a righteous man or woman make God's power available, and that is mighty or effective in its working. You know, we don't have to agree with men, with all of our leaders or all of those that are in authority, but we do have to agree with God and his word to the place where we do his word if we want the results of quiet and peaceful, tranquil, undisturbed lives. We do have to pray for them to be pleasing to God. As the scripture says, how is this pleasing to God? Well, he longs and he desires for everyone, that's everyone, to embrace his life and to return to the full knowledge of the truth. The Bible says to pray on every occasion with worship to God, with clean hearts, free from frustration or strife. One translation says without anger or scheming. You know, Jesus gave us a perfect prayer, didn't he? He said, pray this way: your kingdom come and your will and your way be done. We can add for every political leader and representative and for all those in authority, your kingdom come, your will be done. You know, my prayer today is that you'll put this word to work, that you'll put prayer into a practical practice in your life. Then when you and I put prayer on it, I remind you that God puts his power on it. I want to thank you for your listening today. God bless you until the next time. This has been Pastor on the Porch.